the story of the envious Wezeer and the prince and the Ghooleh. The king above mentioned had a son who was ardently fond of the chase, and he had a Wezeer whom he charged to be always with his son whenever he went. One day the son went forth to hunt, and his father's Wezeer was with him, and as they rode together, they saw a great wild beast, upon which the Wezeer exclaimed to the prince, "Away after this wild beast!" The king's son pursued it until he was out sight of his attendants, and the beast was escaped from his eyes in the desert. And while the prince wandered in perplexity, not knowing whither to direct his course, he met in his way a damsel who was weeping. He said to her, "Who art thou?" And she answered, "I am a daughter of one of the kings of India. I was in the desert, and slumber overtook me, and I fell from my horse in a state of insensibility. And being thus separated from my attendants, I lost my way." The prince, on hearing this, pitied her forlorn state and placed her behind him on his horse. And as they proceeded, they passed by a ruin. And the damsel said to him, "O my master, I would alight here for a little while." The prince, therefore, lifted her from his horse at this ruin. But she delayed so long to return that he wondered wherefore she had loitered so, and entering after her without her knowledge, perceived that she was a Ghooleh, and heard her say, "My children, I have brought to you today a fat young man," on which they exclaimed, "Bring him to us, O mother, that we may fill our stomachs with this flesh." When the prince heard their words, he felt a sure of destruction. The muscles of his sides quivered, and fear overcame him, and he retreated. The Ghooleh then came forth, and seeing that he had appeared alarmed and fearful, and that he was trembling, said to him, "Wherefore dost thou fear?" He answered, "I have an enemy, of whom I am in fear." The gods say, "You asserted thyself to be the son of the king." He replied, "Yes." "Then," said she, "wherefore dost thou not give some money to thine enemy and to conciliate him?" He answered, "He will not be appeased with money, nor with anything but life, and therefore do I fear him. I am an insured man." She left, said to him, "If thou be an insured man, as thou affirmest, beg aid of God against thine oppressor, and he will avert from thee his mischievous design, and that of every other person whom thou fearest." Upon this, therefore, the prince raised his head towards heaven and said, "O thou who answered the distressed when he prayed to thee, and dispellest evil, assist me, and cause mine enemy to depart from me, for thou art able to do whatever thou wilt." And the Ghooleh no sooner heard his prayer than she departed from him. The prince then returned to his father and informed him the conduct of the Wezeer, upon which the king gave orders that the minister should be put to death.